I grew up in Seaman, Saskatchewan here. The best product in Saskatchewan is, it's not their wheat and lentils or potash or minerals, it's the people. These kids were living a dream. Dana was living a dream. I mean, think about this. The bus driver was living a dream. These are all just like you as broadcasters live a dream, or a cardiologist lives a dream, or an orthopedic surgeon, or a farmer. These guys were all living a dream, these people. And in a nanosecond, such destruction. And we wanted them to know we're thinking about them. It's a credit to, you know, and these two guys that I know, they're like sons to me, these two players, in a second, never mind world championships or what, they wanted to be here. And whatever comfort we could bring, and I don't want, hopefully something that we wanted to know, that we wanted them to know how we feel about them, and we'll always be pulling for them. Always, not just today.
We said all along, you know, we're not doing this for media or for anything other than what we said, to come here and try and, you know, put some smiles on some faces that maybe haven't been able to do that in a while, and you know, visit a community that's obviously hurting, and you know, try and help them in any way we can. I mean, obviously, whether it's you know, the smallest way possible, I think it's worth it. You know, it's worth every little bit, every little second to be here, to see, you know, the schools that these guys went to see the rink that they skated on, to, you know, actually meet them, you know, face to face. I think it goes it's a whole different interaction, and I think that makes it so special. You know, there still is that human side left of people, and you know, that, you know, we can come together when people are hurting, because ultimately no one wants to see people hurt.
To help put some smile on some faces and just be a part of this community for a little was, it's heavy, it weighs heavy, and to be around and see the faces. And right away when I heard it, I just came off the ice in a game in Tampa, and one of the guys told me, and just you think of how many bus trips you've been on and how many, you know, how close you are at that age when, you know, all the guys are on the same, you all go to school together, you see each other so much, and to have that torn apart, it was just, you know, whatever we can do to help it in any sort of way, it was, yeah, just jump right in and yeah, do what we can to help this, you know, hurting community. You know, I think going to the one school, you know, when Connor walked in, one of the kids there had an Oilers shirt on, just started, broke down crying, and it was, you know, I think he was just so shocked to see him, and it was pretty special just to be a part of that and witness that, how, you know, how coming here, you know, made such an impact, and how, you know, it was just a really special moment. It's, like I said again, just the way, what the community's been through, to see some kids having a good time, taking their mind off that is kind of what we wanted to do here.